So this video, I'm going to show you how to make a courtyard house, like a modern style courtyard house, something like this picture. It's not going to be exact because I'm always not going to make too much of that details, but I'm going to have it at least somewhere similar, and I'm going to try to make this as a short video as possible. So let's go and hop right into it. Let me bring this video down. So, start a new file project. Standard. This is Autodesk 2017, but this should work on any Autodesk year, Inventor year. So, I'm going to start with blueprints from the top view. So, make the main house, the main building. That should usually be around 40 by 40 feet. I'm going to make it about 40 by 30. I think that's a decent size. Main living room and someone on greeting room. I usually start with the main building and just work around from that, because that's really how courtyard buildings are made. I'm gonna try to reduce this down to like 30-minute video. It might be more, but that's the idea point right here, 30 minutes. So it might be like a speed one. So we made our main building. Let's see. The main building will also have access to like the outside area, but also like a driveway right here, the driveway right here, the wall right here, the hallway. This is this area. Hallway. And about 15 feet. This is the other side, the rooms will be it, like the guest rooms and the other rooms or so on. Make this about 50 feet. That might be too long, but let's see. Oh, yeah, too long. Okay, I think I made an issue with that. So, y'all probably already noticed it, but I was in inches, not feet. So, 40 feet. I think I changed my default, that's why I'm used to it. 30 feet. I'm gonna pause the video. Battery's running dead. So we got that done. Usually that'd be up like 10 feet. Because the main building is what you usually see from the street. This should go in about 30 feet. So the main idea of courtyard houses, so you don't really need a fence. You really have a private, like a living area, outdoor living area. So then go up by 6 feet. And then push this down to 15 feet. 16 feet. Let's keep it even. So these are guest rooms and so on. Maybe a washroom or so. It doesn't really matter. So this will go all the way to 20 feet. 4 foot hallways. And let's put a garage. So garage would be like I'm trying to see, should I make a detached garage or combine it? You still got about 28 feet of courtyard space right here. Okay, I'm gonna just put it on the side. It's gonna be connected, but it's gonna be a side entrance. And from right here, okay, this is how I'm gonna do it. So it's gonna be a both entrance on this side. So a vehicle can go into the courtyard, but it's gonna be grass right here. But the main driveway would be right here. And let's see, I'm gonna ideally make this to a 4-car garage. I mean, about 24 feet wide. No. 16, 32. 32 plus. Actually, let's see, this is 40 feet. So it could be 24. Could be a 2-car right here, parallel. So I'm gonna just add it to this, make it pretty cemetery. Yeah. And we just leave this side open. So this is what we're going for. Simple, but yet still being a courtyard. Now let's make the walls. So get back into the sketch, and we'll use offset. walls usually are 4 inches wide. So that was either right there. Four right here. And additional four. Push that wall back in. So I'm not gonna really worry about the interior much. I'll just show you how to do the exterior. Let's see all the walls completed. Nope. So edit that. Usually it isn't. So you just have to close all the loops of the walls. I don't think that even went through right there, but let's double check. Sometimes it's just, yeah, this went through. Oh yeah, good to activate. So usually I would put like a 9 feet or 10 feet. I'm sure it's 10 feet. This is a pretty wealthy house. Ideally they won't have ceilings and just a one story building. So go back and reactivate that sketch. Let's see if this, yeah, this one ready. So 10 feet. Okay. So this back to you. So we made the first floor. Let's put in some windows while we're at it. So this will have huge windows. The door gonna be on the side by the driveway. I think stairs, I should put the stairs right here. You come in, stairs on the side, the hallway. This main living room, this open, this should be like an open room concept. Kitchen, then back here, there's a bathroom, and there's like a storage room, or like a facility room. I'm gonna go ahead and map that out. I have to keep track of the windows up. So this would be the stairs. I think that was on the last sketch. this will be the stairs at 4 feet. Usually it expands about 16 feet this way. About 16 feet. Actually, I'm gonna go down. I'm gonna see how big the rooms upstairs should be. Yeah, I'm gonna go down that way. Have a split off. A huge bedroom, a bathroom. So I'm gonna go down to 12 feet. With the hall. My house is about 10 feet ceiling. My stairs are about 10 feet. So 10 feet. Then do an additional 5 feet. This is just a rough fitting. It doesn't really have to be accurate. 4 feet wide. So the stairs will go up and then curve. This will allow upstairs to be split in some rooms from right there instead of just a hallway and rooms on the side. It'll be a little bit more fancy and designer. The kitchen will be right here. The open kitchen concept. Yeah, I'm just gonna like that here. Yeah. Usually be about 36. I was thinking about should I make an island, but usually when I'm making items, I kinda just go off the just design what's coming to my mind. So at one moment, I have one idea, then when I go down it, I change the idea a little bit. That's really how it is when building something. There's 24. Wall counters usually ain't that wide. Usually around 24 inches. 36 inches is a little bit more fancier, but since it wasn't connected to a wall, and be accessed it from both sides, I made it a little bit wider. I was gonna make an island, but I don't think I need an island. And this would be about 40 feet, 40 inches, or 48. Because this would have a stove or a sink, something like that. And it would have a bunk on the other side. So actually, it could be 36. And 36. Let me just make it to 40. Wait a second, sorry. So when you design a house, it's best to design as the ergonomics of it. Like if you was gonna live there, how would you like it? Make a bar right here, about 24, 20 inches. should be good. I guess this would be like the kitchen table over here. This would be the TV. Oh, this could be a kitchen or whatever. Now I make some rooms. So this would be multiple rooms right here. A room would go under the stairs, cause that should be like 6 or 7 feet right here, right under the stairs. Get that off. Actually, I'm gonna expand this room to 2. This would go to the garage. This would be like a pantry or something. And this would be a refrigerator right here. I'll set this to 4 inches. So I'm just really leave the interior as on a blueprint stage and just focus on the outside now. Now I know where to put the windows and doors at. So it'll be 6 feet, then I'm gonna have an arched double door. And it should be about 36. 50. 5 feet. I was saying 5 feet, but I ended up typing 50 feet. 50 inches. I don't know, 60. I'm not too sure if that's straight. So this little thing means is a 90-degree angle. Now let's put an arch in that top of that door. So we're gonna go to arch right here, go to tangent. And that arch is a bit too big. go to just a regular top arch, 3 point. So you can adjust how much the arch should be. And this should be like it. Don't want it too like too top or roundish. And then we'll cut this out. It doesn't really matter too much on how deep, because this cutting it out. Cut. Make sure you didn't cut through that at So let's make some windows. So let's close complete sketch. So we're doing this wall, new sketch. And project geometry. Mark the middle point. I'm gonna try to make easy windows if you're gonna make it all simple, same. Let's go to rectangle. A little even sized. Yeah, that's a little even sized. It's not exact, but again, I like keeping too much. That should be good. So copy these. Now, this line. That's how you make easy windows. Get this, cut that all out. It's coming along. I'm wondering should I put windows on the side. But that's a little bit too much windows. No, I'm not gonna put windows on the side. Since it's pretty much going to have windows on the door. I want too many windows, but I just want quite a bit of windows. This is going to be pretty much all windows. Slice graphics, so I got to get a better view of it. So, how should I do this? I'm gonna put a door at this end. I'm just gonna make a simple window pattern. At first I was gonna make a tutorial today, but I figured I had some spare time. Now let's make a pattern. So I go the direction this way and change it. It went the other way, but you know, let's see, do about 200. Yeah, no, do about 4 and 200 pieces. Actually, let's try to 100. Yeah, that's doable. That's doable. And put a door right here. So this is pretty much going to be a regular door, like a regular glass screen door, however you want to do it. So it's going to be 6.5 feet. By 36, actually 40 inches wide. pretty small next to the windows. Yep. And then we're done with that. Go ahead and cut those out. Now this is going to be a little bit different right here, because we're going to make the windows go straight through on the other side. Actually, no, you can't, because I got to put a door right here. Yeah, never mind on that. So here, actually they make a, do the same way we did this one, symmetrical. I'm also thinking of where to put those tiny windows at the top. Have some more privacy. No, I'm just doing that for the bones. So let's do project geometry. Find a middle point. Yeah, the green dot usually states where the middle point. I'm gonna go with thinner windows. So I'll go with blue. I'm gonna go with thinner. And we're just gonna do a pattern to the middle point. Direction that way, about 30, actually 25. Now with middle windows, it'd be easy to put mini windows on each side, because if I did big windows I would have to split the middle one and do the middle one manually. So let's do 4, 5. Yeah, that's good. Once I do that, I'm just copy on the other side. Just mirror this. 5 and Y. Do this. Cut. Now we're gonna put a center door. So it's gonna be the same way I just said, doing big windows. Let's see. Project geometry. Find the middle point. I'm not sure what that was for middle point. Okay, maybe this is the middle point. Usually it's a green dot, but I guess not. Not this time. So I'm gonna put big windows on this side. Just mirror this on the other side. And let's make a 5 inches here. 7 feet. Sometimes you have an angle, you know, it's a direction like that. 7 feet is 7 inches. 60 is 5 feet. 72 is 6 feet. 84. And let's put this about 6 feet wide. I don't like it on feet. 36 inches. See, once you get used to 1 feet, and then you switch back to inches, then go back to feet, sometimes you get confused over there. Let's do 36. And that happens sometimes. 8. That should be good. So I'm gonna cut this stuff out. Sometimes that project geometry interferes with your SVs. So it's come along pretty well. So another thing, should I make flat roof? I'm gonna go with flat roof. No, I'm gonna go with angle. I'm gonna go with angle. Excuse me. So right here, I'm going to show the top of the nose, project geometry, so you get privacy and upright breaking height. So it should be 24 inches wide, making pretty long, about 7 inches. Do about 4 of these, 1 for each one, and it should be about 120, go back, 120, yep, 110. Actually, I'm going to make them a little bit thinner. There's my name on it. Delete this. Edit pen. Oh, cancel it. I do. You can also suppress the dimensions, but I don't think it's. Let's try that. Yeah. That's good. Let's cut down to that. Should be good. I'm not gonna really make focus on wounds up here. Now let's make this garage. So this is gonna be like a 2-entry door garage. Let me go ahead and make this bit off though. I might put some windows over here. Nah, I'm not gonna put windows in here. Help me determine which side is the garage and which side of the house. So the garage door should be about 8 feet. This one with the green sensors. You should put a space right there because that's where the door is into it. So, let's see, 1, 6, I forgot what 8 feet is, but I'm just taking it. This size is about 1 big. Now I'm gonna do 2 different doors. Or I can make it as a bowling door. I'm gonna do 2 different doors. So 8 feet by 8 feet. And then get a little arch. Some reason why I'm going all the way to the bottom. Now it sits. That should be good. Cut. You put the windows like that on this side. Do a pattern. Out of the way. Do it on.
Let's do it to 120. Yes. Is that it? We have this. Put some holes in that. So it's coming along pretty well. Get your design of it. This one is starting the second floor. The second floor only going to consist of the main room. So I have to do a sketch right there. Project geometry. The outline the whole area. And we just gonna, all we're going to do is cut this off. Next should work. Put this. That. The floor should be 1 foot. Now, on this side, do this. The stairs. So we can make the cutout for the stairs. Just send this all the way up. Cut. And now we have to cut out for the stairs. And go back to the floor. Do project geometry again. And just to connect it to that. Yeah, it was. I don't know if it's connected to this. Doesn't matter too much. I'm gonna get back to that later. Stuck a sketch, project geometry. Make sure you split this. So do I need to? Actually, no, I don't. So, we're gonna leave that open if you did exactly where I did it. I'm gonna show you a way, a little trick. So, just make the walls right here offset. Yeah. Close this up. How far is this offset going? Okay, I'll leave it. About 10 feet. That should be good. That's 10 feet coming up. Is that 10 feet? Alright, I figure that's not 10 feet. There we go. What's that? Can you remember looking? Now, actually, I can make this a two-story courtyard, but I'm not. So, I'm gonna show you the trick I was about to say. How to make the roof. It's gonna be a slanted roof. I'm not gonna make a. Let me show you the design. Single slope and single slope. I may connect with the internet. But back to it. So I'm gonna start from this side. This should work. My calculations is right. So I'll determine where the 10 feet cut off point. And they're always doing it. But, let me just go straight up. Actually, let me define which side is the side of the wall. Obviously, I also could just split in half. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. That should be 10 feet. Half of it.
It's good enough.
So with this, all I'm gonna do is gonna go like this. Everything from that part is gonna get cut off like this. That's it. Get too much in it. Try to find a shade area. This is one of the hard parts of this software. Here we go. Flip back. And probably do the same thing with this. Next to it. And sketch. The geometry. I might have a little hiccup because this area is going to intersect. I want to look normal too, so I'm going to show you how to do that. So, okay. Doesn't have to always line up to the wall. Like this. This is just cutting. And sketch. Cut that out. And that should be good. Somehow I feel like a blow there. Now, so you got an idea of how it's going. So from right here, I do this. New sketch. Usually I always make it to like a 4 feet, like a offset. So like if somebody was walking under the like the house and by the side, it won't get wet. And it helped have a foundation. And let's look at that. Do 12. Use that's how thick the roofs are. Alright, this doesn't have to be exact. That. Now we have the roof fit. So from right here, on the sketch, screw. Right now it should be kind of self-explanatory what I just did. Other way, make sure you don't use cuts. Join and make sure this all the way lines up. And from right here, just kind of do the same thing I just did right there. Do sketch, slice graphics. So right here, you're not going to go too far deep in it, because you don't want this area to go up like that. because, you know, that's the only thing I have trust into right there. But I'm gonna make this wood a little bit thinner. If I can find it in there. Then you see. Cut out 10. Go down. This shows a 90 degree angle from that. Let's see, can't get 90. Let's see, I think I'm at an angle myself. Yeah, I'm at an angle. Well, it can't be 90 degrees angle, but this is an angle. This is exactly perpendicular to that. Let's see. Well, it's just a rough sketch, so. Let us waste too many times trying to be a zap. Finish sketch. Sometimes with this little design, I get too a zap with the measurements. See, this is where I was trying to avoid that. But it's a small little detail, so it shouldn't be an issue. So that's the gutter roof. Looking pretty good so far. It's pretty much the same way with this. Let me stop this. So I paused the video to make sure it's not too long, and it's already twice as long as I thought it was going to be, but at least I'm showing you the full path to doing this. So right here, this garage is going to be a little bit different from the rest of it. Actually, I just realized that I had to do it kind of similar to that. Project geometry. Okay. Go up significantly, not too large, but yeah, like this. The sketch. Project geometry. You don't always have to use project geometry, but it helped me find the angles. Yeah, personally, I like using it. So I'm gonna cut that piece off. Doesn't matter too much if you cut off too much, because I'm gonna show you. It actually would be better if you do it like that. So finish sketch, we're gonna go on this wall. Yes. I'm gonna go out 8 feet. Because usually people with a garage and cars, they have a little bit slightly out. And go down like this. So it's kind of like it's connected to that building over there, but it's not. This thing, the system thinks it's related to that sketch over there. So
Just bring this out. That's it. Bring out a little bit more. Like that. This would be a good solar power panel area. So just thinking a while ago, I'm bringing this roof down this way. Should be okay. Let me make the windows first. And this is the front windows. Then that's pretty much all that matters. Actually, I probably should do the side windows right there. So, I'm not there. See how I want the rooms up here. And then complete that wall. And sketch. And sketch. So let's just do this. Now let's put actually I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna make the blueprints for this floor. So how the room was gonna be, this was gonna be a hallway. Actually like a big room right here. Like this. Bathroom right here. Master bedroom right here. Bedroom right here. Split bathroom, should I say? Yeah, split bathroom right here. This is kind of big room. Yeah. Split bathroom right there. Bedroom right here. And yeah, that should be good. And walk-in closets could fit within that. How wide is that? I think it's like 8 feet. Right. Almost 7 feet. And that's pretty decent. So they access to that bathroom. This bathroom right here. That should be enough. I was going to put a balcony, but it's really needed. So let's put two other size windows right there. I
actually, since it's the front of the house, even if the walls doesn't line it, that the windows should be pretty symmetrical to the bottom floor's windows. So, one big window for every three windows. See how long should this be? 300. Nope. 150. 115. Almost there. 115. 115. Yes. Do those. Great. Should we go on too far? So right now I can pretty much make the base for the foundation. Usually I save the foundation for last just in case I need to make edits that I can't do from the top. All things pretty much done. So I just get a bit saying that the foundation isn't really matter too much. Where's the garage? And make sure you don't drop cement here. Let's see about, I'm going to do just 12 inches. Doesn't really matter, you could do an inch, you could do a centimeter, as long as it looks like a and I'm going to remove the bottom sketch. So, right here, non-visible, like that. And just to fill the windows, all you do is, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to show you, give you an example at the end. And all I'm going to do right here is this. Since the top floor doesn't have to be exactly 10 feet, because it's the top floor. It's going to get cut off a little bit. Guess that was an incomplete sketch. There we go. That should have connected. Nope. Top sketch. That should be good. How? Like how? Something like that. Let's connect it. Let's connect it. So go like this. Done. Go back to sketch. This is the main cylinder, so it's kind of need to be thick. And since this is the front walkway, make this thick too. Go the other way. So I also think that doing this, no, that's too much. I'm gonna put a pillar right here, but no, I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna bring it out some more, but it's not gonna be that far out. Join, make sure you put join. Right, I have some, just a little bit. You can overlap just a little, but not too much. Yeah, that's good. The sketch. Project geometry. I'm not sure why that project you don't see didn't go through all the way. That doesn't come out. There we go. Let's go. Should be connected. Yeah. Do about 5 feet. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Make windows as you feel needed, but as this far this goes, I'm pretty much done. Been well past the time I was trying to do. So to make windows, just do this: new sketch, project geometry. Part of the geometry here, and just add as you go. But I'm gonna go ahead and add it. And do about, see, 2 inches, and go the other way, and that should be good. And just do clear. Alright, you gotta hit new part. Yeah, go to edit this. Make sure you hit new edit feature. New solid. So it doesn't actually connect it. Once you do that, do clear. Raise up. Clear. So you can tell some more. And do project geometry on this. Project geometry. Okay. And do the same thing, same process. Do solid. Go to array. And hit clear. We go down to my favorites, since I already got used that before. And done with that. And that's the end of it. Actually, I'm paint the roof black. Let's see. Got a black. Favorites. Let's get it so it can look better. Yeah, sign as your textures you go. I'm gonna go ahead and sign my textures, but I don't think you need any recordings for that. So, go ahead and do it. We smile.